Hey everybody, it's Rich at RMAutodiag, and we're going to use FORScan today to see if we can make a new key for a Ford Transit Connect. Okay, first of all, we're just going to quickly ID our new key, make sure we've got the right chip in it. So we got a 4D63 chip. We'll put the original in here as well. Make sure we've got the right one. And the same. Right. So what we're going to do is let's get the ignition on. Let's get the program started. We'll swap over to the screen and we'll see what we can do. Right, okay, so we're all logged into this. So we'll just have a look, see what DTCs we got. We've got none in any of the modules, so we're happy with that. Let's go down and we'll see if we can do any PATS programming. So we'll click into it. Come down and press play. Is the vehicle equipped with a keyless push start? No, it's not. Right, so we've just got a bit of a warning here saying about ignition key programming, difficulties experienced, a few bits and pieces here, just giving us a few warnings. So we're going to just carry on and go, yeah. Okay, so we want to do ignition key programming. So there's already two keys stored. And it says that up the top here as well. So we can erase module initialization if you'd put a new instrument cluster in it. We can clear the keys out, which we don't want to do. So we're going to ignition key programming, click OK. Okay, so set the ignitions to position 0 and insert the new key. So I'll just turn it off there. Grab the new key and we'll put it in. So what I'm going to do, just got the new key in with the ignition on and we're going to press OK. Alright, so it's going to do the access to the database with encodes. And it's going to sort out the outcode for us as well. Would you like to do it now? Yes. I don't know how long this is going to take. As I say at the top here, it is saying it's generating the codes. We're at 2% down there. We'll just wait and see what it does. It says diag on the dash. Okay, so it's all finished. It says about the key has not increased yet, but we've got to turn the ignition on and off and then recheck the monitor to see if we've got 3. So we'll come off, back on, press OK. No, we got 2. Okay, so I tried the key procedure a couple of times and it doesn't seem to be giving me a higher key count. It says everything's successful, but probably what my thoughts are there's probably more likely an issue with the key that I've got rather than the program itself. So what I'm going to do in the interest of keeping the video a bit shorter, so I'm trying not to make them over 10 minutes. What I'm going to do is I'm going to order up a few different transponders and I'm going to go through and try a few different more and see if we can get it working, just to make it a fair test. As I say, I don't think it's the program that's the problem. I think it's more than likely the key. So I'm going to do a few tests on that, and maybe convert it over to an 80-bit chip from the 40-bit chip as well, just in case that's a problem, but I don't think it is on these earlier models. And we'll go from there. So, all right, come along for the next video. There'll be a part 2 to this, and we'll see if we can get it working. Cheers.